look here at the method of undetermined coefficients. This is called one because later on I'm going to do two and it's going to have sines and cosines in it. But right now we're just looking at this one that's like kind of the easy stuff. And by easy, I mean like fake easy, not like actually easy, just easier than like, I don't know, tensors. I don't know. I got nothing. Anyway, so we're looking at a problem like the method of undetermined coefficients where we are going to be given right now just a nice constant coefficient, second order, linear, ODE. And on the right, we have something in the form e to the something times some other random function. So basically the idea is that you're going to start these kinds of problems off by finding a particular, a homogeneous solution. So a homogeneous solution is where you've got something like this. CY. So these are all homogeneous. So you want to solve that problem, just the equals zero problem. And then you're going to, normally you'd say find a particular solution, but we're going to guess a particular solution that is in the same like genre of the thing on this side. So we'll say guess OYP that matches. I'm going to put matches like this. Matches the right-hand side. And then, of course, the third step is to solve, or I guess say that the y is equal to the homogeneous plus the particular. So that's kind of a standard thing. And then possibly solve for initial conditions. But maybe not. If you're not given them, don't worry about it. Really, the thing that's going to take up the most of your time is this second one right here. And that's what we're going to look at. And when I say matches, I'm going to say what I mean by that. So method of undetermined coefficients is a way to guess a particular solution based on how it matches the right-hand side. So basically the idea is if you have something like this, y double prime minus 7y plus 12y equals 4e to the 2x. Essentially what you're going to do is you're going to guess, and assuming we found a y homogeneous, you're going to guess a particular solution that looks something like that. Okay, now there's some caveats, but we'll just talk about this in a second. You could also say, well, if I have e to the 4x plus 3 times e to the 2x, then I would guess a particular solution that was ax plus b times e to the 2x. And similarly, if I had if I had the same thing, but it was equal to, 3x to the fifth plus, 4, e to the 2x, then I would guess something ridiculous. So these are all particular guesses. I would guess ax to the fifth plus bx to the fourth. I have to guess all the little intermediaries because they might come into play. Times e to the 2x. Got it? Okay, so let's see what I mean by all this. So let's look at that original problem that we had. And you'll see what I mean by guessing all this stuff. And you'll be like, but I don't understand. All right, so let's do an example. So we've got y double prime minus 7y prime plus 12y is equal to 4e to the 2x. Now our first step is to solve the homogeneous part of the problem. So I've got y homogeneous. So that means y homogeneous prime prime minus y homogeneous prime plus 12y y homogeneous is equal to 0. Now for that to be the case, that means that I can write my characteristic equation. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, you need to go review something else because you can't do this until you can do that part. So r is equal to 3 or 4, which means I have a homogeneous solution in the form c1 e to the 3x plus c2 e to the 4x. Beautiful. Okay, I love it. Now what I want to do is I want to guess a particular solution that's in the form of the thingy on the right hand side. So I'm going to guess that y particular is equal to a e to the 2x. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to plug this into my original problem. So particular is equal to 2a e to the 2x prime, and then y particular double prime is 4a e to the 2x. Now if I plug that in, I can plug in this for my y double prime. So I've got 4a e to the 2x minus 7, then I've got y prime, which is this guy, and don't know. I just think the coloring helps. 2AE to the 2X. And then I have 12Y. And then regular Y is just the original guess. AE to the 2X. And that has to equal 4E to the 2X. Okay, so that is a particular solution. Now I'm going to factor out E to the 2X. And I end up with 4A minus 14A plus 12A is equal to 4e to the 2x. Now I can divide, how do I say this? Go back. I can divide both sides by e to the 2x because you can't see what I'm doing. That's why I can get away with it, because you can't see me, can't see it happen. I know that this cannot be equal to zero, so it's okay to divide because it's like a number, so 3 raised to any power is never going to be 0. And that number is just 2.7 something. So I can safely divide by that. So I've got, what is that? 10 and 2 is, I don't know, 2? 2? Yes. 2a is equal to 4. So that means a is equal to 2. So if I zoom out and you see what I'm doing, I've got my initial problem, my initial guess, my particular solution was A times E to the 2X. So basically the idea is if I take that 2E to the 2X and I take the derivative and the double derivative and I plug it in, that is a particular solution. And I know that my general solution is going to be my homogeneous plus, oh, I can't write, writing is hard. So there's my homogeneous plus my particular solution. Now, if I had an initial conditions, I could apply it here, and I would be able to get the constants C1 and C2. But this is kind of what we mean, is that you make a guess that matches the format of the thing on the right-hand side of the equation. You take the derivative, you take the double derivative, you plug it in, and you're good to go. Make sense? Okay. Now, here's where we run into some trouble. So there is a caveat, and I'll give you an example. So let's... Example caveat? I don't know. That's not a good way to say that, but I think you get where I'm going. Let's do the exact same thing. And I'm going to make this instead equal to 5e to the 4x. Now we've already shown that the homogeneous solution is c1 e to the 3x plus c2 e to the 4x. Beautiful. So you're like, okay, cool. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to guess my particular solution again. A, e to the 4x, yp prime, 4a. And you're going to be like, maybe you're already telling that something's going to go wrong. Maybe you're not. Maybe you're just blindly trusting me. That's okay, too, because I'm specifically leading you astray. Understand that it's only for pedagogical purposes. Do, 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 do. So I plug this in. 16a, e to the 4x, minus 7, y prime. For a e to the 4x minus 12 y a e to the 4x is equal to 5 e to the 4x. Alrighty, so I'm going to factor out an e to the 4x and I end up with 16a minus 28a minus 12a, and that has to equal 5 e to the 4x, and I can very easily divide both sides by e to the 4x because that can't ever be zero. And I end up with something awful. Wait, I missed a plus sign. There we go. Yep. I've got 0a equals 5, which is impossible, right? There's absolutely no way that this is going to happen. Why did this happen to us? Well, because we were goofy. This here, this e to the 4x, is just a version of a homogeneous solution. Therefore, by definition, it has to equal zero because that was the whole point. So then the obvious question is, well, what do we do if it just can't fix it? Make it better. So to make it better, we're going to make a better guess. And the better guess is to basically come in and say, well, since it can't be e to the 4x, maybe it's x times e to the 4x. We can prove this mathematically, but I think we've already done that in other videos, and honestly, at this point, just believe me, have I ever led you astray? Of course not. Anyway, so let's just show you how this is going to work out. So I'm going to do the same thing, and I'm going to say, okay, well, if I guess this, now it's going to be a little bit more annoying to make this double primey stuff, but I've got a e to the 4x, and then 4ax e to the 4x, and yp double prime, 4a e to the 4x plus 4a, oops, equals, do, 4a e to the 4x, and then 16a e to the 4x. So if I want to go plug these thingies in, you can't see what I'm doing anymore. All right, so I had the original thingy. All right, the double prime thingy, minus 7 times the single prime thingy, and then plus 12 times the non-primed thingy, and that has to be equal to e to the 4x. So I've got, I'm actually going to pull an e to the 4x out. Here, e to the 4x. So I'm going to pull an e to the 4x out just to make it a little easier. 4a plus 4a, I guess I could have done that in my head, 16a x. Did I drop an x? Yes, dropped an x. There we go. And then I've got a plus 4ax, and then I've got ax. And let's see what's going to happen. So obviously these thingies are going to go away, and I've got 8 minus 7 is 1, 8 minus 7 is 1, like that, and then I've got 16ax minus 28ax plus 12ax, that has to equal 5, and my x's all go away, so I have a equals 5. And look, that's actually something that's mathematically legitimate. Yay! Happy thoughts all around. Okay, so that means that my particular solution is actually 5x e to the 4x. So basically what happened is we had to throw that extra x in there so that as we took derivatives, we got that. So you see, when we were taking derivatives without the x, we only had one term per derivative. Basically what the extra x allows us to do is add some more terms into the derivatives that allows us to avoid getting that 0 equals 5 kind of situation. So that means that my full solution, I keep zooming out, my full solution is y is equal to c1 e to the 3x plus c2 e to the 4x plus 5x e to the 4x. And if I had any initial conditions, then I would go and I would apply them there. Okay? So it kind of gets you an idea, so let's do a quick overview. So, overall strategy. So first of all, we are going to solve the homogeneous. Except, that's not how you do that. We're going to solve the homogeneous. Then, you're going to guess a particular that matches. And I know we already wrote this, but now we're going to do the full caveats and everything like that. That matches the right-hand side. Now, if your particular solution matches y homogeneous, add an x. So, for example, if we add y homogeneous is this, then we want to guess a particular solution of if we had a 3 or a 4, x e to the 4x or 3x, only if they match completely or a portion of it. Now here's the other thing. In fact this is really the same thing. I'm going to say, or if the particular solution already has an x, I shouldn't even say add, I should multiply. Has x, do x squared. Do is better because it's less specific. So say you had a homogeneous solution that looked like, and we've had these before if you've seen any of the videos. So if you have something like this, so you already have an x, well obviously if you just added an x, you would end up in the same situation. So you want to do a x squared. like that. So normally your guess would be, ax squared, e to the 3x. So essentially you're going to match the right-hand side, and then you're going to see, do I need to multiply the whole thing by x, or do I need to multiply the whole thing by x squared? Then you're going to take derivatives, match coefficients, and then finally, you're going to write y equals y homogeneous plus y particular. So that's kind of all of the basic theory behind it. So the best thing to do really is to go, The best thing to do is to go practice just making good guesses over and over and over, because actually the algebra part is the, again, for lack of a better word, more straightforward part. It's making the right guess, because if you can't make the right guess, you're kind of in trouble. So I'm going to put together another video where we just do nothing but make good guesses and get some practice doing that.